Hello everyone. So today we are going to see effect of load on skeletal muscle contraction. So we have to see here afterloaded and freeloaded condition. This is very important experiment in skeletal muscle contractions. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe it. Let's get started. Afterloaded condition. The condition in which the load starts acting on muscle after the contraction has started. As you can see in the image, there is a muscle shown and a weight of 1 gram is hanged on a muscle having other 2 gram weight resting on a platform. So when muscle contracts, this 3 gram weight acts on muscle when it contracts. So the condition in which the load, that is 3 gram, starts acting on muscle after the contraction has started. This condition is called afterloaded condition. The example is weight lifting. So as this person, it flexes the elbow, the weight acts on muscle. So this is afterloaded condition. Next is free loaded condition. So the condition in which the load acts on muscle before it begin to contract. So here you can see the muscle is already stretched and hanged with 1 gram weight. So before it start contracting, the load acts on muscle. So after that, with the same stretch, it contracts. This is called free loaded condition. For example, the dumbbell exercises, the dumbbell workout. For both the procedure, work done can be calculated. The formula for calculation of work done is equals to F into H, where F is load in grams and H is actual height to which weight has been lifted. To calculate H, the formula is small h is equal to small l divided by capital L into capital H, where capital H is height of contraction, which you can see on the drum, the amplitude of contraction. Capital L is distance between fulcrum and righting lever. So this is fulcrum and righting lever. This is capital L. Small l is distance between fulcrum and point where load acts. So from fulcrum and to the point where load acts. So this is small l. By this formula, we can calculate work done in both the condition. Observation of afterloaded condition. So in afterloaded condition, when we touch this afterload screw to the lever, to the fulcrum, this was the graph we got on stationary drum. As you can see, the amplitude of contraction or height of contraction gradually decreases. So the observation is height of contraction gradually decreased, and if we calculate work done that increases up to an optimal load, then it decreases. There is decrease in durations if we compare with free loaded condition on moving drum. We can find here that there is decrease in duration of contraction and relaxation phases as compared to free loaded condition. So this is after loaded condition and this is free loaded condition. You can see the height of contraction is less and even the duration of all the phases is decreased, that is contraction phase and relaxation phase. But the contraction phase started later, so latent period is increased. Now let's see observation of free loaded condition. So this is the graph when we loosen the screw, afterload screw from fulcrum. So you can see every time the baseline descend down. But if we calculate the amplitude, the height of contraction, the height of contraction first increases. So this height of contraction is less than this one. So first it increased, then it decreased gradually. So work done also follows the same. Work done increases first with increase in load, then decline afterwards. If we then compare with afterloaded condition, so this is afterloaded condition and this is freeloaded condition. So in freeloaded condition, there is increase in duration of contraction and relaxation phases, but decrease in duration of latent period as compared to afterloaded condition. Now let's see what are the mechanisms behind these observations. So first, freeloaded condition. So freeloaded condition in which the load acts freely at rest before a muscle contracts. So in these conditions, series elastic components is stressed, increasing the initial length before contraction. So initial length is the muscle length before it contracts. So stretching the series elastic component increases the initial length. According to Frank Starling law, force is directly proportional to initial length of muscle fiber. So which lead to increase in height of contraction. Hence, the work done is also increased till a limit. So as the length increases, this graph is telling the length tension relationship. When length increases, how tension increases. So on x-axis there is length. So when muscle length increases at a level, the tension increases, but after that the tension decreases. As you can see, the cause of this is, you can see the interaction or cross bridges between thick and thin filaments. So the tension is highest when there is optimal number of linkage between actin and myosin filaments. When there is overstretching or increase in length further, the actin-myosin linkage decreases as they are stretched. So tension decreases. So here, with increase in load to a optimal limit till the optimal number of cross linkages are present, there is increase in work done, and this is called optimal length. In afterloaded condition, the series elastic component stretches after the contraction has been started. So there is cross linking between actin and myosin filaments starting, then it is being stretched. So because of this, latent period increases, because latent period is because of the series elastic component element. Then load, we hang then load and we increase the load in this condition. So here the load acts as resistant to muscle and it decreases the number of linkage between actin and myosin filaments. Because of this, it decreases the contraction period and relaxation period. Hence, the work done increases till an optimum load, then it decreases because the muscle is unable to lift the load. So first is resting length. Resting length is muscle length under natural condition in body in relaxed state. As you can see in the image, from here 70% till 130%. This muscle length at rest, resting period, the muscle length can exist in our body. So this length is called resting length of a muscle. Initial length, the muscle length before it contracts is called initial length. So before every contraction, the length of muscle present is called initial length. Next is equilibrium length. Equilibrium length is length of a muscle in relaxed state when it is cut free from its bony attachment. So when any muscle is cut from its bony attachment, the length achieved is equilibrium length. Then is optimum length. Optimum length is the length under natural conditions at rest in body and at which the muscle develop maximum active tension. So as you can see on the graph, this from here to here is resting muscle, resting length of muscle. So this range of length a muscle can have in body. But there is a muscle length where active tension, so this graph is of active tension achieved when we increase length of muscle. So when we increase length, there is increase in tension. So at a length, when we have maximum active tension present, that length of muscle is called optimum length or optimal resting length.